Maybe you've heard of PostgreSQL, but how does it relate to Citus and Hyperscale and Azure Arc? Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by JY, a program manager on Azure Data. Thanks for being with us today.
Anna, thanks for having me.
Always a pleasure. And today we're going to be talking about Azure Arc enabled PostgreSQL Hyperscale. Now, before we get into that, you know, typically on this show, we've only talked about Azure SQL and SQL Server. Can you talk to me a little bit about what Azure brings to customers that are currently using PostgreSQL?
Yeah, sure. So Azure provides to customers a great choice of data services, in particular when it comes to open source database engines. Azure already offers managed services for MySQL, MariaDB, and PostgreSQL. Azure offers the PostgreSQL database engine in a few different deployment options. One is Azure Database for PostgreSQL Flexible Server. Flexible Server is a new deployment option for our managed Postgres database service in Azure. It is in preview right now. Number two, Azure Database for Postgres Hyperscale Citus. Hyperscale Citus is a built-in deployment option for our Postgres managed service in Azure. And what it does is that it enables you to scale Postgres horizontally. The Hyperscale Citus uses a Citus extension to transform Postgres into a distributed database system. Citus distributes the data and do your queries across multiple nodes in the cluster. So I should mention as well that the Citus extension is open source and that the Citus team is now part of the Postgres team at Microsoft. So Hyperscale Citus fits particularly well for multi-tenant applications like SaaS application and real-time analytics application that are heavy on processing data. And Hyperscale Citus is offered both as a managed service in Azure and as a hybrid solution with Azure Arc enabled Postgres Hyperscale.
Awesome, cool. Thanks for that overview and kind of explaining the differences. Now, at the end, you were mentioning Azure Arc. Can you tell me a little bit more about what that is and how it relates to PostgreSQL Hyperscale?
Yeah, sure. So first, let's put things in perspective. This is about Azure Hybrid that Microsoft offers to our customers to solve the increasing complexity they are facing in terms of number of applications they have to manage and the variety of infrastructure they have to manage, right? From on-premises to multi-cloud, it's very complex. So Azure Hybrid comes with three pillars. We have Azure Stack, Azure IoT, and Azure Arc. Azure Arc brings Azure services and management capabilities to any infrastructure. It encompasses Azure Arc for servers, Azure Arc for Kubernetes, and Azure Arc for data services. Kubernetes provides the abstraction layer that makes it possible for Azure Arc to run on any physical infrastructure. One of the services that are available today with Azure Arc enabled data services is Azure Arc enabled PostgreSQL Hyperscale.
Cool. So you mentioned that Postgres is offered in Azure in two deployment options, and you mentioned this earlier, single node and hyperscale. And then it's also offered in two ways, this Microsoft managed service and also this customer managed hybrid type of solution. Now, when customers think about this, how does Azure differentiate here?
Sure. So Azure is the only cloud that provides two deployment options for the Postgres database engine, single node and hyperscale, both as a managed service and as an hybrid solution. These provide the flexibility and the scale that our customers tell us they need. Why is that important? So let me give you an example. A few days ago, I was discussing with a bank in Southeast Asia. They want to modernize and move to the cloud. However, like quite a few of our customers, they cannot migrate all workloads overnight. And for some compliance regulatory reasons, they also need to keep some of the workloads on their premises, right? Azure enables them to modernize in their terms at their pace using Azure Postgres Hyperscale, both as a managed service in Azure and on their premises with Azure Arc enabled Postgres Hyperscale.
Okay, got it. So if I were to try to summarize, because this is kind of new to me, Azure Arc enabled PostgreSQL Hyperscale is a hybrid solution that's going to do two main things. It's transforming the standard PostgreSQL database engine into a distributed database, which is going to allow really big levels of scale, especially because of the Citus extension, which is now part of Microsoft and is also open source. And then additionally, I'm going to be able to run this in really any physical infrastructure. So whether that's my data center or my customer's data center, or maybe at the edge or even in other clouds, is that kind of right?
Yes, Anna, that's it exactly.
Okay, cool. So what does a customer get when they start to use this Azure Arc enabled PostgreSQL Hyperscale, wherever it is that they're using it?
Sure. So today in preview, customers can deploy on any physical infrastructure and any Kubernetes. They also get the typical capabilities and features of Azure Database for Postgres Hyperscale. For instance, backup restore, server parameters, using Postgres extensions, scale up, down, and out. They also get monitoring and log analytics capabilities since any deployment ships with Grafana and Kibana. They can also upload their Azure Arc inventory information to the Azure portal and there benefit from the unified manageability experience. In terms of tooling, customers have the choice between experiences with command line interfaces with AZData or kubectl, to which AZData is integrated, or graphical user interfaces tools like Grafana, Kibana, Azure Data Studio, and the Azure portal. And let me show the Azure portal now on the screen too, so that you can see what it looks like. And we have done a lot of work to provide seamless experience between the portal and Azure Data Studio. So you have the same experience with the product, whether you are connected or disconnected with an offline tool.
Awesome, very cool. This looks really great. You know, I obviously still have a lot to learn, and I'm sure many of our customers and viewers are interested in learning more. How would you recommend folks get started?
So, Anna, the simplest way to do that is for customers to go and look at our documentation. There, they will find step-by-steps about how to deploy the product and how to use it. And more importantly, they can find our Azure Arc Jumpstart program, which provides them with a set of ready-to-go deployment that they can use to try out the product, right? That is very useful in particular if our customers do not have a Kubernetes deployment available or if they don't know much yet about Kubernetes. So if there is just one URL to remember, it's aka.ms/Azure Arc Data.
Awesome. Cool. That's really exciting because I didn't know that you could kind of go in and take a look at this stuff without having to deploy anything to kind of, you know, get your feet wet and get used to the service. So that's really cool. We'll be sure to put a link to that URL that you mentioned in the description, as well as a link to a few other things to get started. You know, JY, thanks so much for being on the show today. I personally learned a lot, and I think our viewers have probably learned a lot as well. To our viewers, if you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.